Make connections in a different kind of way in 2020. And I know most of us learned to appreciate the things we used to take for granted.
Used to get my hair done, used to have my nails long, used to wearing makeup every day, used to rush to work and have no time for fun and spend half of my life on full highways. Then the world closed down, stuck inside this town, home with the family, all new reality. Four walls and a door, nothing's like before, you and me and no distractions. So let's just keep it simple, there's so much we can do at home. Build a fort in the living room, have a pillow fight, grilled cheese in our bed, and we look at stars and eyes. Keep it simple, disconnect the telephone, rip up all the calendars, cancel every plan, catch up on The Bachelor, we'll still laugh again. The day we kept it simple, always used to worry, always in a hurry, let all of the minutes just fly by. Focus on the wrong things, double tapping, scrolling, fall asleep while asking myself why. Then the world closed down, stuck inside this town, home with the family, our new reality. Four walls and a door, nothing's like before, you and me and no distractions. So let's just keep it simple, there's so much we can do.
So if you couldn't tell, I was reading a script I wrote. It just ended. And so for this portion, I just put, thank everybody. But I mean, how do I even put to words what you guys meant to me this past year? I don't think you realized, one, how I fell back in love with my channel. I don't know if you're new to my channel or not, but I started making videos over a decade ago, before YouTube was YouTube, before the word influencer was coined. I was just a girl in high school who had a passion for makeup and beauty, and I felt like I had no one to share with it. And all those years ago, I found a place where I had a community of people who felt the same passion I felt. In years past, I grew up, the community changed, and I just didn't feel a part of it anymore. And this year, becoming a mom and becoming a parent, being pregnant, going through this journey has really become a new obsession for me. And for the first time in a decade, I feel that community again. It's way different than the beauty community. I'm filming my voiceover.
It's dinner time and we're waiting for you. We've been waiting for you for 20 minutes, so it's time to go to dinner.
It's been 20 minutes. Okay.
Yeah, let's go.
Okay, Sassafrassy. I feel like I might have to film more of a thank you, but if I don't get time in the new year, I will do my best to continue bringing some awesome content in 2021.
And finally, hello 2021. How are you? Dear 2021, I would like to talk to you like I am going to predict you. Here are my predictions or hopes for you. Today, my daughter is 6 months, so at the end of this year, my daughter will be a year and a half. I have not planned out the future too much. I don't really know what's to come. I kind of learn things as I go, one day at a time, but I think by a year and a half, you will be walking and talking. I don't know. Apparently, I didn't learn until I was 3, but I'm definitely a late bloomer in a lot of things. I can't wait until Arrow's hair is long enough that I can do those little pigtails that I see people do, and it's like 5 strands of hair on either side, and it's like this big. I just think it's the cutest. It's a little thing, but I'm definitely looking forward to it. I hope we will have another matching moment or two. I really gotta get those in until my daughter realizes I'm not that cool and she doesn't want to match me anymore. I'm guessing we don't live in this house any longer by the time I make my update to this in 2022. But even if we don't live here any longer, I'm sure it will still hold a lot of great memories. I hope that we are all healthy and happy in 2021. I'm also a realist, and I'm sure in 2021 we'll have our own set of challenges to overcome. There will be tears had on everyone's end. Like, I'm sure when we start getting some baby teeth in, we'll have tears on Arrow's side and probably on the parent's side too.
I hope I still get the honor and the privilege of another year getting to connect, learn, teach, just spend every week with you. I honestly really do enjoy it. And if there is one thing I learned in 2020, it is how much I am fortunate and lucky and honored and all of that amazing stuff to have you guys in my life.
Because honestly, I just have a really awesome group here right now. Like, I feel like, especially in the mom space, you guys are really nice. So if we could keep it like this for another year, I would be in heaven.
And I look forward to seeing you back this time next year, 2022. We can look at my reaction. We can look at your comments. You can reflect, see your hopes, your dreams, how your year went in review.
But I also hope to see you a little bit sooner, like next week. How about that?
Okay.
I love you guys. Bye.